Let's kick back and talk about some R&R.
Rest and relaxation.
No, risk and return. Our best way of measuring an expected return of an investment is with a probability distribution, where we take each possible return R and assign it a probability P of R, or P sub R, or PR.
Meow.
Thus, the expected return is the weighted average of these returns times their respective probabilities, calculated as E of R is equal to the sum of R times P of R for all R. Now, a lot of people get anxiety when they see the equation for expected return, but that's expected. Then there's the variance of a return, which is the expected squared deviation from the mean, calculated as var of R is equal to the sum of all R minus E of R squared times the probability of R. Then there's the standard deviation, which is equal to the root of the variance. Now, this is where you should be anxious, but again, that's pretty standard. Now, the standard deviation of the return is known as the volatility of the investment. You like that? The volatility. Are you ready for an example? No? Well, too bad. Let's say I flip this coin and you offer me $4 if it lands heads, and then you offer me negative $2 if it lands tails, because you're stupid and not good at making bets. The two return possibilities are $4 or negative $2, each with a probability of 0.5, which is the chances of heads or tails. You know this. So the expected return is 4 times 0.5 plus negative 2 times 0.5, which is 2 minus 1, which is 1. So the expected return of this investment is $1. So what's the variance, you don't ask? Well, let's plug it into our equation. We know that the probabilities are still 0.5 for each, and we know the two returns are $4 or negative $2. So plugging that into the equation, we get that the variance is the sum of 0.5 times 4 minus 1 squared, which is 0.5 times 3 squared, plus 0.5 times negative 2 minus 1 squared, which is 0.5 times negative 3 squared, which equals 0.5 times 9 plus 0.5 times 9, which is equal to 9, so our variance is 9, which means the standard deviation is the root of 9, which is, anybody? I'll wait. What's the square root of 9? I'll wait. Beautiful day, isn't it? The square root of 9 is 3! I'm so disappointed that you didn't answer that. So this investment has an expected return of $1 and a standard deviation or volatility of $3. I hope you enjoyed this video on expected return, but I also know that your teacher forced you to watch it, and there will be more. So basically what I'm saying is, it's expected you'll return.